מסכת מנחות, page 3, we are 3 lines from the top of the page. Another question the Gemara asks, according to what we learned in the previous daf, the Rabbah resolution, חטאת העוף שהיזה דמה למטה, לשם עולת העוף תרצה. So you have here the case of a bird sin offering. So the priest took the blood and sprinkled. When it's come to Chuta Sikra, the red line, so it was below the Chuta Sikra, below the red line, for the sake of a bird burn offering. So here they said, Teratze, so it's effect acceptance, which means that it's Ratzui, the Korban Ratzui, it's accepted. De Maaseh Mochichin Aleha, the Chatat Ofi. Because he said that since you see the action that performed, that's basically prove that it is a bird sin offering. The iolata ofi, because if you tell me that this is a bird burn offering, as the Kohen said, lemaala hava avidlei umitzui hava avidlei. So he should do it above the Chuta Sikra, above the red line, and he will have performed the act of squeezing instead of sprinkling, as we explained in the previous daf. We said that there are 2 points. The sin of a bird offering is different than the burn bird offering. One, the blood of a burn of the sin offering, it's basically under Tachtit HaMizbeach, the lower of the altar. The burn bird offering, it's above the red line, Chuta Sikra. Then the two is that the blood of bird sin offering is made by sprinkling, by Hazaah. Blood of a burn offering, you do not have any hazaah, you do not have any type of sprinkling, you only have squeezing, you only have mitzui hadam, which means when the Kohen take the blood of the sin offering, of a bird sin offering, and place it under the Chuta Sikra, under the red line, it's basically two evidence that prove that that's opposed the whole intend when it's come to a bird burn offering. So Gemara said, "Hachei nami." Indeed, according to the view of Rabbi Shimon, such a bird offering meratzed, its effect acceptance, and therefore fulfilled the obligation of the owner. And he said, "Hachei nami lefi she'ena menachot domot lizvachim kama." Because what he said is that meal offerings are not similar to slaughtering of offering, which means that they are not similar to slaughter animal offering, lizvachim, velo leofot, but did not say that they are not similar to a bird offering. So therefore, the menachot is basically similar to a bird offering, to ofot, and also, therefore, in the ofot, Rabbi Shimon machshir alav. So if you have a case of chatata, of a sin, bird sin offering, that the Kohen sprinkled the blood lemata mechuta sikra, below the red line, for the purpose of a burn offering. So as you see, according to Rabbi Shimon, regardless, the moment we have the intent, machshava shelo lishmo, that basically caused the korban to be deficient, to be pagum. Kodshei kodashim sheshchatan batzafon leshem kodashim kalim. So as we explained many times, we have two different categories when it's come to zvachim versus menachot. It's only kodshei kodashim. So here we talk about situation that you have the offering of kodshei kodashim, of the most sacred order, that one slaughter in the northern part of the temple courtyard, which is a requirement that applies only to offering of the most sacred order. Now, what happened here, he did it for the sake of Kodashim Kalim, of the lesser sanctity. So he said, Li Ratsu, they should accept, effect acceptance for the honor. Ma'asehen mochichim alehem de kodshei kodashim ninu. So their action performed on them prove that they are offerings of the most sacred order. De'i kodashim kalim, because if they are offering of the lesser sanctity, badarom hava aved lo, they should perform their slaughter in the southern part of the temple courtyard. Eimu de amar hamanara, af badarom. The Gemara responded and said, you can say that the Torah hold that can slaughter the lesser sanctity even in the southern part. But it means badarom velo batzafon mi amar. So if you tell me that it's only in the southern part and not in the northern part, so he said, where is it? Ditnan. This is the something we learn when it's come to a lesser sanctity of offering in the tractate Zvachim. We learn it on page 55. Shchitatan, their slaughter, bechol makom bazara, in any place in the temple courtyard. So it means that lesser sanctity offering can be slaughtered even the northern part of the Azara. You have no proof from here that if he slaughtered the offering in the northern part, that it's not a offering with a lesser sanctity. Kodashim Kalim is another challenge. Kodashim Kalim Sheshchatan Badarom Leshem Kodshe Kodashim Li Ratsu. So here we talk about lesser sanctity, that one slaughtered in the northern part of the temple courtyard for the purpose of most highest offering, Li Ratsu, show effect acceptance. Ma'asehen mochichim alem de Kodashim Kalim Ninu. Because the action that perform on them prove that they are offering of lesser sanctity. The equal check of the shim, because if they are the most higher level of the sanctity, but Safona Vavidlu, they should be slaughtered in the northern part of the temple courtyard. Amrei, so they are in fire saying, meaning people who see the act of slaughtering will say, Kodshei Kodashim Ninu, this is the one of the most highest sanctity. Ume'avadu de'avar v'shachat lo'u badarom. And the Kohen transgressed the mitzvah of the slaughter them in the northern part of the courtyard and slaughter them in the southern part. Yad David, one of the commentators, expand on that. But so it means you do not have a proof from here that if you slaughter the offering in the southern part, that's not the most highest offering. So the Gemara challenged it and said, Yachi machavat l'shem marcheshet nami. If you tell me that people might suspect that an individual performing a rite of an offering in a incongruous way, then if the Kohen removes the handful from a pan meal offering for the sake of a deep pan meal offering as well, one who sees that this Kohen remove a handful from the, for the sake of the pan meal offering might say the same thing. This owner took a vow to bring a meal offering in a deep pan, and in fact he bring it in a pan. Amar hai ba marcheshet nadar, v'hai de mait la ba machvad de marcheshti. Umebaru de avar batia ba machvad. So it's basically the owner transgressed the mitzvah of bring a deep pan, and he brought it in a pen. So why Rabbi Shimon maintained that such a meal offering satisfied the obligation of its owner? So the Gemara said, Hatam over there, ki name b'marcheshet nedar, ki maitela b'machavat, machavat hatya. When that case, when the Kohen removes the handful from a pen meal offering for the sake of a deep pen meal offering, so even if the owner took a vow to do it well, to bring a meal offering in marcheshet, in a deep pan, when he bring it in a pan, is considered a valid pan meal offering. And therefore, you see here the intention of the Kohen, it's basically false, it's recognizable false. Kiditnan, האומר הרי עליי במחבת. That's something that we're going to learn in Mitzvah Shem in the Mishnah on page 102. You have a fellow who said that I take upon myself to bring a meal offering prepared in a pan, and he brought in a deep pan, ve'vi b'marcheshet, or vice versa, b'marcheshet ve'vi b'machavat. So the Gemara said, ma she'vi yevi, whatever he does, he did it, it happens. It's still valid, and the Kohen performs the rite of the meal offering that he actually brought. V'idei nidro lo yatsa. However, when it's come to fulfill his obligation of from his vow, he must bring another meal offering to fulfill his obligation. So the Gemara asks, v'dilma. Maybe the one, the Kohen, that have improper intent maintained, amar zo le'avi b'machavat v'vi b'marcheshet, ki detnan zo le'avi b'machavat v'vi b'marcheshet. So again, you have a pen and you have a deep pen. Vice versa. V'b'marcheshet v'vi b'machavat, arei zo psula. So you said it's disqualified because it not fulfilled the vow. So if that's the case, can Rabbi Shimon say that such a meal offering satisfied his honor obligation when the intent is not recognizably false? So the Gemara responded and said, "Lerabanan hachinami." It's not necessarily that the thought of the intent of the Kohen is false. Rashi said that that's basically, if you follow the Mishnah, that's follow the sages, and according to their view, you do not have a proof from that Maaseh HaMincha that the Kohen intends something that is false. But anyway, לרבנן החינמי, לרבי שמעון, כיוון דאמר רבי שמעון, אף ידי נדרו יצא, even if fulfilled his vow, אלמא קביעותא דמנא ולא כלום הוא. So you see here that the designation of the vessel for a meal offering is nothing according to Rabbi Shimon, and there is no difference in this regard, whether he said this is for a particular type of meal offering, and there is no difference whether he said this is incumbent upon me to bring a particular meal offering. Because you see in both instances, v'loshna amar zo v'loshna amar alai, the unique actions of each particular meal offering prove its identity, and therefore the owner fulfills his obligation regardless of the Kohen improper intent. אלא מעטה, עולה ששחד לשם חטאת תרצה, והי זכר, והי נקבה. So if that's the case, you have a burn offering, that one slaughter for the sake of a sin offering should effect acceptance. So his action proved that it is a burn offering, and this burn offering is always male, and that sin offering is a female. So they said, כיוון דאיקה שעיר נשיא לזכר הוא לא ידיע. Because you have a goat of the Nasi, that it's a male, so you don't know if this animal is a burn offering or sin offering of the Nasi, and then it's a gender is not conclusive proof. Amar l'shem chatat yachid ma'ika le'meimah. He said for the sake of sin offering of individual, which is always female. So they said, v'tu chatat yachid sheshchata l'shem ola teratze. Individual sin offering that's slaughtered for a burn offering, that will be a effect acceptance, as such a sin offering is always female. The chatat nekeva v'ola zachar, and burn offering is a male. So the Gemara said, it is difficult to discern whether a lamb is male or female. Why? Mikasya ba'alya, because his private part is covered by its tail. So his gender is not considered proof of the type of offering being sacrificed. Hatein achecha deika kivsa. We understand when it's a female lamb as his sin offering. So its tail makes it difficult to discern its sex. But aiten siira ma'ika lemema. But when Casey brought a female goat, what can be said? Ela ben zcharim lenekevot lav adaya dau de inshei, which means that it's not the people mind. People not take a notice of the offering gender. So therefore, the aspect of the animal is not considered discernible. Pesach sheshchato l'shem asham leiratzei, דהי בן שנה, והי בן שנתיים. That the Pesach, the Paschal offering, is 1 year old, and the guilt offering is 2 years old. So the Gemara said, כיוון דאיקה שם נזיר ושם נצורה, that both of them, the guilt offering of Nazirite and the guilt offering of a leper, is 1 year old, la psikale. It's not necessary that the thought of the one who slaughtered, it's total false. It's not definitely clear. Amar leshum hasham gzelot uleshum hasham meilot. Ma'ika lemimar. If he said, I slaughtered a lamb, this lamb, for the sake of a guilt offering for robbery. Or he said, I am slaughtered this sake for the guilt offering of for misuse of consecrated property. Ma'ika lemimar betu hasham gzelot v'hasham meilot. The guilt offering for robbery and guilt offering for misuse sheshchatam leshum pesach yiratzu, if he made it for a paschal offering, should affect acceptance. The pesach ben shana v'ane b'nei shnatayim, the paschal offering is 1 year old, and this one the second year. Ela ben shana leben ben shnei shanim live adadai to the inshei deika ben shana demichzeke ben shtayim. We have 1 year old that appear like a 2 years old. And there's a 2 year old that appears as though it's the first year. Sayir sheshchato l'shem hasham liratze. The high tzemer, the high se'ar. The Gemara challenges, said if you have a goat sin offering that one slaughter for the sake of guilt offering should affect acceptance, because we know for sure that it's not a guilt offering, and the guilt offering is a ram with white wool, and that goat has black hair. So the Amrei Dichra Ukamanahu, people will say that this is a goat, is actually black ram, and they may indeed mistake for a guilt offering. Egel Ufar Sheshchatan L'Shem Pesach V'Hasham L'Ratzu. Take a calf, take a bull, that one slaughtered for the sake of either a paschal offering or guilt offering, should effect acceptance. So you know that for sure this animal cannot be either offering as a calf of a bull offering, is not sacrificed either as a paschal offering or as a guilt offering. Degel v'far b'pesach v'asham leka. So the Gemara said, en achinami, it is true, and you follow the view of Rabbi Shimon, that such offering effect acceptance for the owner. Page 3b, umay zvachim, and what Rabbi Shimon mean when he says that meal offering is not similar to a slaughter offering. So they said rov zvachim, most slaughter offering. So there are certain slaughtered offering whose preparation, which is unique to the particular offering, is proof that this is an offering. So in those instances, Rabbi Shimon maintains that the offering fulfilled the obligation of the respective owners, despite the improper intent. Rava amar lo kashya, kan bekometz mincha leshum mincha, kan bekometz mincha leshum zevach. You have to differentiate between the kohen that removes a handful from a meal offering for the sake of a meal offering, over there when you remove a handful from a meal offering for the sake of slaughter offering. And the Gemara elaborates, Rava elaborates, and he said, if one removes a handful from a meal offering, mincha leshum mincha, vezot torat mincha, torah achat lechol amenachot. Mincha leshum zevach, vezot torat mincha, vezevach loktiv. So I see the signals that we're getting close to services. So by force of circumstance, I'm just going to read to the end of the shiur, v'atana. Hopefully in the future we can expand. ותנא מפני שמעשה המוכיחין עליה כאמר, הכי כאמר, אף על גב דמחשבה לא מנקרא והיא תיפסל, וזו תורת המנחה, תורה אחת לכל המנחות. מאי, אבל בזבחים אינו כן? אף על גב דשחיטה אחת לכולן, וזו תורת המנחה, וזבח לכתיב. אלא מעתה, חטאת חלב ששחטה לשם חטאת, דם לשם עבודה זרה, לשום חטאת נזיר, לשום חטאת מצורה, תהא כשרה ותרצה, דאמר רחמנא, וזאת תורת החטאת, תורה אחת לכל חטאות. לרבי שמעון, האחי נמי, לרבנן האמר, חטאת חלב ששחטה לשם חטאת דם, לשום חטאת עבודה זרה כשרה, לשם חטאת נזיר, מצורה פסולה דהנעולות בעדי ונינהו. רבך הברידי רבה מתני ללחול ולפסולה, ושחד אותה לחטאת לשם אותה, אותו חטאת. רבה שאמר לו, קשיה כאן בקומץ מנחת מחוות לשום מרחשת, כאן בקומץ מנחת מחוות לשום מנחת מרחשת. מנחת מחוות לשום מרחשת במנה כחשיב, מחשב, ומחשבה במנה לא פסלה. מנחת מחוות לשום מנחת מרחשת במנחת דפסלה במחשבה כמחשב. והתנה מפני שמעשיה מוכיחין עליה, כאמר, אחרי כאמר, אף על גב דמחשבה מנקר, היא תיפסל. ומאי, אבל בזבחים מנוקן, אף על גב דשחיטה אחת לכולן, זריקה אחת לכולן, קבלה אחת לכולן, וזביחה דפסלה במחשבה כמחשב. אומר לרבה חברי דרבה לרבי שמעון, חרבה משום בלולה, מהי אמר רבי שמעון, אמר לי לשום בילה באלמה. יחל לשום שלמים נמי לשום שלמים באלמה. הכי אשתה, התם זבח גופה יקרי שלמים, דכתיב המקריב בדם השלמים, הזורק את דם השלמים. הכי מנחה גופה מיקרי בלולה, וכל מנחה בלולה בשמן, כתיב בלולה בשמן יקרי, בלולה סתמה עלה יקרי. כולו כרבה לא אמרי. דעדי רבה, מחשבה דמנקרה פסל רחמנה. כרבה לא אמרי, וזאת תורת למשמע להו. כרבה שלא אמרי, משום קושיה דרבה חברי דרבה. מילדה דפשיטה לרבה להגיסה, או לרבה להגיסה, מבעלה לרבושה, דבעי רבושה, ואמרי לבא מן הרבושה, מרבי יסי, מנחה לשום זבח, מה לי, אמר רבי שמעון, פייג' 4. תם עד רבי שמעון משום מחשבה, דמינקרא לי, לה פסלה והמחשבה דמינקרא הוא. או דילמה, תם עד רבי שמעון משום דכתיב, וזו תורת המנחה. וזבח לא כתיב. אמר לי כלום, הגענו לסוף דעתו של רבי שמעון. כדי רבא לא משן אלי משום קושייה דאביי, כי רבא לא משן אלי משום קושייה, וזאת תורת החטאת. כדי רבא שלא משן אלי משום קושייה, דרב אחא ברי דרבא.